give you a little bit of what she's going to bring to the table for this Ellington event, which you just heard the promotion for. Here's Liz Wright. You're listening to Black Beat New York, the Flo Wiley Show on WHCR 90.3 FM. We are Harlem Community Radio.
Say, I see the words behind your eyes. By the time you show me what you're hiding, it won't be no surprise. Why do you keep on whispering, talking with your face turned away? Say that love don't come easy for you. What makes you think I ain't afraid? Let me in or let me go. It's time you tell me where you're standing, babe. I won't go down if you say no. Open up your mouth and say it, babe. Speak your heart. Speak your heart. You used to say the world goes away when you're with me. I don't want to be your reoccurring dream. Let me out, let me stay after the sun rises. I want to be.
That's an absolutely lovely piece of music. It's Liz Wright from her CD, The Orchard. That one is called, of course, Speak Your Heart. I thought it would be appropriate to play it because this play that we're going to talk about in a minute, what's it called, Little Mermaid? One of the more strange fairy tales that was ever written. But I am sure kids, being the complex beings that they are, have a ball with it. So, and you all, of course, know it very, very well indeed. So, but before I go on and bring on my guests and talk about The Little Mermaid, I want to tell you about a couple of other things that are happening for our young people that I want you to be aware of. So you know what that means, right? That, of course, are the opening strains for the Nutcracker Suite. And there are two Nutcrackers that are coming up that I want you to know about, because this is that season. You know, once a year you get to see every Nutcracker that's done. You get to do it. So here's two of them that I want you to be sure that you add to your to-do list. The Dance Theater of Harlem is having their Holiday Delight Sunday Matinee this coming Sunday, December 7th. They're having two performances only at 2 p.m. and 5 p.m. featuring the Dance Theater of Harlem School with excerpts from The Nutcracker. They are also appearing in the Apollo's Ellington at Christmas. And they are also having a Kwanzaa celebration and special guest artists. That's going to be a lot going on. And two performances with the Dance Theater of Harlem on Sunday, 2 and 5 p.m. at the Everett Center for the Performing Arts on West 152nd Street between Amsterdam and Convent Avenue. And the number to call for more information is 212-690-2800. That's 690-2800. And of course, you can check them out online, dancetheaterofharlem.org, which you ought to do anyway, just to keep up with what they're doing year round. And the Uptown Dance Academy is presenting their 19th annual Black Nutcracker Holiday Show Thursday, December 18th, 2 weeks from now, at the Hosto Center for Art and Culture on the Grand Concourse in East 145th Street in the Boogie Down Bronx. Two daytime performances at 10 a.m. and noon, and one evening performance full length at 7 p.m. You can go for more information to uptowndanceacademy.org and find out about those events. The Ellington at Christmas Nutcracker Suite is Saturday, December 13th at 3 and 8, and Sunday, December 14th at 3 in the Apollo main stage. But I'll tell you more about that later on. You're listening to Black Beat New York, the Flo Wiley Show. I want to welcome to Black Beat New York my guests here in the studio. I want to welcome Jeff and Katie and Meredith and Lauren. Welcome all of you to Black Beat New York.
Thank you for having us.
Oh, good. I wanted to, they were going to speak. All right. Now, three of you are graduate students in the City College of New York's graduate program in educational theater. And we're going to talk about the after-school drama program that's a part of that. And Lauren, you are the communications and marketing manager handling social media and other communication outreach for the program itself.
Yes, and also a grad student.
Grad student.
Yes, going to be graduating in May, hopefully.
Excellent. Excellent.
As well.
All right, good. Yeah, well, hope springs eternal. All right, so this production that you are doing is the third that I've heard of. I've heard of Aladdin, and I heard of, oh God, it just flew out of my head.
The Jungle other Book.
Yes, right. Now,
and
Pinocchio. Oh, Pinocchio, I hadn't heard about.
And this is our fourth.
This is your fourth production. So what I want to talk with you about, Lauren, in a minute, is the after-school program. Sure. Well, let me talk with you about that first, and then I want to talk with Jeff and Katie and Meredith about how this one that is taking place on Thursday, from 5:30 is an event, and then 6 o'clock is the show at PS 161. We'll talk about that in a minute, but tell me about the after-school drama program, how it came to be, why it exists.
Thanks. Well, actually, this is the result of a community partnership that we have at City College with PS 161. So Jennifer Katona, who heads up our program in Ed Theater, formed a relationship with the principal, Miss Price, and in period of 4 years, we've managed to be able to put on four shows and also go over to the school and do a number of other programs as well. So students in our graduate program get hands-on experience with the students at PS 161. They get a theater program, we get the experience, so everyone's happy in the end.
That is wonderful. And you're only in the fourth production of this. And over how many years is that?
Four.
Over 4 years. That's wonderful. I'm so delighted that the principal had the foresight, if you will, to go through the bureaucratic challenges that were there for her in order to make this happen. I'm really glad that she did. It's a win-win for everyone. So this production, you've decided to do The Little Mermaid. What a story. That Hans Christian Andersen, I don't know about him. The Little Mermaid is a cautionary tale at best, but it's one that we absolutely love because it has hope, and God, if we can use a little hope right about now. So how do you all make this out? Before the show, I was asking what you did individually, and you told me that, Jeff, you work with costumes, Meredith, you work with set, and Katie, you work with community outreach and for this production. Now, how do you pull the kids together once Lauren and the suits, shall we say, have made it happen and it's turned over to you to create the Let's Make a Show aspect? What do you do? And how many kids do you have, and how do you pick them?
They choose to come. They sign up.
Okay.
So there's a lot of talk, there are assemblies to get the kids excited before auditions, which we did have auditions.
Excellent.
And that was a really fun process that we were, everybody in our program, or in that class. How many of us are there?
18.
Uh-huh. So all the whole class participated in the process.
Yeah, we are all directors. So 18 different people plus Jennifer Katona and some teachers at the school are all collaborating to make this happen.
Okay,
so
all right.
So it's really special.
And we did a lot of prep work before we even went into to work with the students, with ourselves, to come up with a director's vision, a unified vision that we all were on board with, that we could impart to the students during the rehearsal process too.
So you are all directing students?
We are, yes.
Uh-huh. It's beginning to get clearer to me. All right.
And 15 others as well.
And 15 others as well. And you're directing together. How interesting.
It's a very unique process.
So that's the PhD that follows the master's. All right. And so then, Katie, when you are, the group is together, are the actors also involved in the production, the set and the costumes?
Yes, very much so. We spent the majority of our time rehearsing for the show, and they would generally be split up into whatever group they're in and working with a different director and then rotate. And now we're at the process, we're putting everything all together, and we have some student helpers who are going to help backstage. I think, how many is it? Just a couple this year.
Just a few. They're like our stage managers.
Right? Excellent.
But many of the kids have contributed in some ways, and have to bring in, some of their own articles of clothing and things that. So
welcome to community theater.
And they also really got to help, they got to give their suggestions and feedback at the times that they did work with the adults on those elements.
Yeah. Oh, that's awesome. That is a good experience for them to have. What has been let me go there. What has this taught you guys? What have you learned from doing this?
It's taught me about the art of collaboration and how important it is to establish an ensemble of actors and directors and designers and administrators to come together to put on the show.
That is amazing, and I can only hope that as the kids are watching you learn that they're also learning it as well. Yeah. What has it taught you?
Well, two things really. One, that it's just become very evident to me through this process how necessary the arts are and how much being a part of a program like this means to some kids.
Yeah.
Several of our kids are, yes, having to miss rehearsal, but it's because they're auditioning for performing arts high schools throughout New York City because they found out about musical theater through this program.
Awesome.
Many of the kids ask us, are we coming back tomorrow? Even when we're not supposed to be at their rehearsals. And you can just see what a difference it makes in especially this nice time where people are preparing for the holidays and the demeanor of the kids. So I think that's really important. And I think that that the arts are, like I said, very necessary. And the other thing that I've learned is that just how much work it goes that it must take for a drama teacher in a classroom who has to teach all day to be able to produce theater after school with 18 of us doing it. It is still challenging and exhausting, and many, arts educators do all of that in addition to everything else they have to do, and they do it by themselves.
Sure. And eventually you all may end up doing it by yourselves as well, remembering these lessons in collaboration that you learned. So what has it taught you, Mary?
I think it's taught me the importance of simplicity. When you come in and you have these really elaborate plans, you know, you only have so much time, and we're all working in concert, and we, you know, all want to work with the actress who's playing Ariel, but she can only be one place in one time. And so really making sure that you're clear and simple, and then just listening to the kids, listening to where they're at, and listening to the fellow directors, and really trying to anticipate their needs and support them. I think that has been a really fun thing for me to just like be able to hold people up and help them through the process.
That's awesome. These kids are very, very lucky that you are such whole people, and that you have opened yourself and given yourself, committed yourself to this as completely as you have. I know that it's going to be awesome. So let's talk about Thursday, the 11th of December. Now, I saw here that it starts, the program is at 6. It's at PS 161 Elementary School, which is at 499 West 133rd Street, which is between what and what?
Convent and Amsterdam.
Between Convent and Amsterdam on 133rd. And it is free. I must say that, okay? Mm-hmm. It is free. Don't cost you nothing. There's an email address where they want you to reserve, but if you grab the kids and come, I'm sure this is a school. They'll have room for you. But here's the thing that I found so interesting. And this question is for Katie, our community outreach person. You're preceding the show. The show is at 6.
Yes.
At 5:30, you're having a community potluck.
Yes.
You didn't have enough to do. Now you're going to feed everybody.
So we really want to encourage members of the community to come and support, you know, students in their community doing theater. And we hope that everyone will join us just for some nice refreshments before the show and mingle with your neighbors and meet some of the teachers and directors who worked on it. We just thought it would be a nice way to get, you know, people excited and to come together before the show, and hopefully more people to see the show.
Yeah, that would be great. Well, I'm encouraging my listeners to come out. When I was thinking about it, talking to you all, I was thinking earlier about talking to you all tonight, I was thinking that here's a great way for auntie and godmother and grandmother to give mom and dad some time, either together or some time to shop, pick up the kids and bring the kids out to this. I cannot tell you how many show business biographies I've read, and they say, I remember when I was a kid, my fill in the blank took me to see fill in the blank, and what an impression it made on them that they remember long into their adulthood. And so you have the opportunity to create that kind of experience for some child, and you have the opportunity to do it for free right in your own neighborhood. So, and who doesn't love The Little Mermaid? I mean, that's a love story. It's got singing and dancing and interesting costumes, I'm sure.
Beautiful costumes.
Beautiful.
Some of the students designed their own headpieces that they wear.
Wow.
And they're very excited to show them off.
Oh, lovely. You guys have really found that creative spark. To me, the arts is a spiritual thing.
Definitely.
You know, it's so much more than any individual piece of it. It is really everything that goes into it is a part of what makes it so wonderful. So we're talking about The Little Mermaid, Thursday, December 11th. 5:30 is the community potluck. 6 o'clock is the program, and it's at PS 161, 499 West 133rd, between Convent and Amsterdam. It is free, and you can reserve at this email address. For those of you that like to do these things, ccnyeducationaltheater@gmail.com. ccnyeducationaltheater@gmail.com. But here's the thing. Just show up. Grab a handful of kids and bring them to the school. Even if you don't come to the potluck, if you just come and see the show, please be on time. You know how I am about that. 6 o'clock is when the show starts. So you can come and you can see The Little Mermaid with a local cast of with some original costumes and headpieces. And Meredith, we didn't get to talk about the set. Talk to me about how we're going undersea.
The set is beautiful. We have this beautiful fabric that's creating some of the water scenes that the kids are using in really interesting ways. So a lot of times the kids sort of become part of the set, which is really fun. So everyone can be involved. And
they become the sea?
Yes.
Oh, lovely, lovely.
They've been a part of set dressing. We've been doing different projects with them so that they have a real hand in the set. And the art teacher collaborated with us from PS 161, and she has actually had the kids painting part of the set.
Oh, how wonderful. So, yes. There's that collaboration thing again. Yeah, it's really, really working. So is now, let me go back to you, Lauren. This is the fourth. So that means you are the school, rather, because you're graduating, as are all of you eventually, planning to do this annually.
Absolutely.
So this is a relationship with the school and the principal at PS 161 that we hope will continue.
Absolutely. And we actually do a number of different programs with the school. This is definitely the biggest in the sense that, you know, this is the big show every fall. But we also do arts integration residencies. So we have students in some of our classes in the program go in and work with kids towards things like literacy, but using theater. So we call that arts integration. So most of the kids at PS 161, because the kids in this show will be 6th, 7th, and 8th graders.
Okay.
But the younger grades have been exposed to theater through different programs that we bring in. So by the time that they're in 6th grade, they've been exposed to some theater. They get to see their peers performing, you know, so that's what hopefully gets them excited to be in the drama club. Because what you said is right, you know, your experience as a kid, and I'm sure, you know, we can tell our specific stories of seeing not just live theater, but seeing kids do live theater.
Yes, that's it.
That's when I think you can place yourself. Mm-hmm. So as we walk around the school and, you know, I've been a part of, you know, I worked with some kindergarten students personally, you know, but so they get to associate theater with something really positive, expressing themselves and aspire then to audition and be in the drama club. So all the kids in the school get, you know, some kind of exposure. Sometimes we even do pre-show lessons. And it's really all, you know, for us, it's all about art advocacy. And getting them excited and giving them a chance to express themselves.
Well, I'm so glad that whoever it was, Soba, reached out to our general manager here at the station to let us know about this program. Here's what I want to do. I want to have some of the kids on. So we can't do it before next Thursday because they're can't add another thing to what they have to do. But for subsequent years or for subsequent productions, I'd like to bring them, have them come on and talk about what the experience is like for them and maybe do a scene for us, a short 2-minute something. All right.
They would love that.
We can do
that. That would be wonderful.
Excellent.
We
okay.
have some incredibly talented kids in the neighborhood here.
Yeah. I don't doubt it.
Incredibly talented
very, very
kids.
Impressed.
I don't doubt it. I really, really don't doubt it.
I like the spotlight a lot. Not shy.
Excellent. Well, thank you very, very much to Jeff and Katie and Meredith and Lauren, graduate students and staff. Staff?
Yeah.
Yes, faculty staff at the City College of New York's Graduate Program in Educational Theater. I've been looking for a master's. I might have to look into this.
It's a great
Your
program.
After-school drama program, The Little Mermaid, Thursday, December 11th, 5:30 p.m. is the potluck, 6 p.m. is the show at PS 161 Elementary School. Please write this down. It's a free show next Thursday. 6 p.m. Come early and have refreshments, but the show starts at 6. PS 161 on 133rd between Convent and Amsterdam. It is free. If you don't show, if you don't call to or email, that's okay. Just show up. It's a school. Who ever heard of a school having not enough room to hold a community? Standing room is a good thing, all right? So show up and enjoy yourself seeing The Little Mermaid presented by our local celebrities, the students of PS 161. Thank you very much, all of you, for coming on the show. Any last comments? Okay. No. Wonderful.
No, just thank hope you. To see everyone yes. at the show, and thank you for having us.
This has been
a lot
much.
Of fun. Thank you so much for your passion for the arts.
Oh, gee, that's what I'm 13 years and counting. All right, thank you very much. You're listening to Black Beat New York, the Flo Wiley Show. Here's a little Oscar Peterson to get you in the spirit of the season.
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Backed by popular demand, after sold-out performances last season, the world-famous Apollo Theater presents an all-new staging of Ellington at Christmas Nutcracker Suite, featuring Broadway stars Norm Lewis and Priscilla Baskerville, with performances by Liz Wright, Jason Samuel Smith, students from the Dance Theater of Harlem, and more. Musical direction by David Berger. Performances are December 13th and December 14th for three performances only. You heard me, three performances only. Tickets are available at Ticketmaster.com or visit www.apollotheater.org for more information.
The Harlem Hospital Center Department of Food and Nutrition Services hosts its annual food drive on Monday, November the 10th through December the 24th. You can donate unexpired, non-perishable food products to any food bank receptacle located throughout Harlem Hospital. All food collected will be donated to Harlem Mothers Save. This is your opportunity to help provide food for families in need during the holiday season. Harlem Hospital is located at 506 Lenox Avenue at 135th Street. For more information, call Sean Shivers at 212-939-1936.
You're listening to Black Beat New York, the Flo Wiley Show. Thank you so much for tuning in. I promised you some Carmen Lunday, and I'm going to get right into it. This is from her new CD called Soul to Soul, and this track I especially love. It's Between Darkness and Dawn. You're listening to Black Beat New York, the Flo Wiley Show.
There have been so many times when longing left me weary, talking to my shadow, looking in the mirror for some comfort in an empty room. Resigned to the quiet, resigned to the still, torn between the darkness and the dawn. Sunrise through my window, shining on my sorrow, lighting the horizon with hope that tomorrow I could ever love again. Love someone like you who's not afraid to feel between the darkness and the dawn. If I give myself to you, my dear, must I give my soul away? Don't want to make that same mistake again, giving everything to someone who's so afraid. It's been lonely for your love. I wanna be wherever you are. I need someone like you who's not afraid to feel between the darkness and the dawn. I need someone like you who's not afraid to feel between the darkness and the dawn. Must I give my soul away? I need someone like you who's not afraid to feel between the darkness and the dawn. Sunrise through my window, shining on my sorrow, lighting the horizon with hope that tomorrow I can ever love again. Sunrise through my window, shining on my sorrow, lighting the horizon with hope that tomorrow I could ever love again. Love someone like you who's not afraid to feel between the darkness and the dawn. Oh, yeah. I need someone like you who's not afraid to feel between the darkness and the dawn. Someone like you who's not afraid to feel between the darkness and the dawn. Ooh, in the lonely hours, in the lonely hours, between the darkness and the dawn.
You're listening to Black Beat New York, the Flo Wiley Show, and that was Carmen Lundy from her new CD, Soul to Soul, Between Darkness and the Dawn. I love that particular song. It's wonderful. Some of you, well, let me just say for me, I was introduced to Carmen Lundy. I, you know, knew her name. I thought I knew who she was until I saw her perform last spring, I believe it was, at Harlem Stage Gatehouse, the tribute to Mary Lou Williams that Jerry Allen wrote, no, Dr. Farrar Gray wrote it, and Jerry Allen did the music and arranged it, and Ipatha Murkison directed it, and Carmen Lundy was the featured vocalist. Oh my God, she just wore me out. She was absolutely awesome. And so when I saw that she was coming to town to my favorite jazz club in New York City, the Jazz Standard, I said, I got to get her CD and play some music for her on the show. I have to tell you that I came in last Wednesday evening and took time out from my Thanksgiving preparation, and she called in from LA and we recorded an interview, and I don't know what happened, but it was not there when we went to get it. So I don't have that interview, but I have her music. And you can please believe that I'm going to play some more of it for you. But I wanted to just tell you that if you are a fan of Carmen Lundy, you want to get to the Jazz Standard. She's there from the 4th through the 7th. The Jazz Standard is at 116 East 27th, between Lexington and Park. It's so easy to get to. You take the 6th train to 28th Street and walk around the corner. Or if you are, you know, you got it like that to have a cab or a car, parking is not a problem. Shows are at 7:30, 10, and 11:45. Now, the Jazz Standard, that's the jazz club that's downstairs below Blue Smoke, Danny Meyer's barbecue joint. Oh, man, it's such a great combination of good music and good eats and good atmosphere. Why is it my favorite jazz club? Because they have a no talking during the music policy. And they enforce it, baby. I've seen some folks, some personalities get asked to be quiet when the music is going on. And I love that. I appreciate that so much. When I'm at a jazz club, I'm there for the music. I'm not there to overhear your conversation. So Carmen Lundy, jazz vocalist, composer, arranger, and visual artist. Check out her website, CarmenLundy.org, and see some of the artwork that's on there. It's absolutely beautiful. Anyway, she opens tonight and runs through the 7th, 7:30, 10, and 11. 11:45 is only on Friday and Saturday, and it's at 116 East 27th between Lexington and Park. The new CD is called Soul to Soul. It is just such beautiful, beautiful music. I'm going to play another track for you. Yeah, let me set that up. And to give you another idea of the kind of music that's on that CD. But if you love great jazz vocalists, you want to check out Carmen Lundy this weekend at the Jazz Standard. Here's some more of her music from the new CD, Soul to Soul.
Out loud, watching the clouds roll away from me. I'm imagining how I might sing a song of love to you. When something you said went to my head, turning me around. Don't you know how I feel about you? Doesn't it show how I feel about you? Nothing so special about myself that's really so different than anyone else. I asked for so much, but what could be now?
fulfilling my dreams to the sky. And what we have is what is at hand. And lately it's been you and I. Don't you know how I feel about you? Doesn't it show? Stories of love I've been told. Love's just a moment that we sometimes hold. If it means something to you, then what could be more than enough for what we had? Fulfilling our dreams to the sky. We have is what is at hand, and lately it's been you and I. Don't you know how I feel about you? Doesn't it show how I feel about you?
Simply wonderful music. You're listening to Black Beat New York, the Flo Wiley Show, and that's Carmen Lundy from her new CD, Soul to Soul. Don't you know how I feel? That was Patrice Rushen on piano, Daryl Hall on bass, Jameson Ross on drums, Mayra Cassells on percussion, and Randy Brecker on trumpet on the tune I played before. Between Darkness and Dawn, which she is co-writer. She was on vocals, guitar, Rhodes, and percussion. Patrice Rushen was on keyboards, Daryl Hall on electric bass, Jameson Ross on drums, Mayra Cassells on percussion, Jerry Allen on the Fender Rhodes, and Carol Robbins on harp. Lovely, lovely CD, Soul to Soul. It's a good gift to give yourself. I always start my gift giving by giving myself something first, and then I'm in the spirit to give all to everybody else. All right, here's some things that I want to gift you with, some things going on in the world of the arts that I want you to know about and take advantage of during this season. And let's not forget, with everything that's going on, what the reason for the season is. It's a tough time right now. So hold on to those you love. Tell them that you love them. Show them that you love them. Okay? And let's be careful out there. The 19th annual Black Nutcracker Holiday Show of the Uptown Dance Academy is Thursday, December 18th at the Hosto Center for Art and Culture on the Grand Concourse in the Bronx. There are two daytime performances at 10 a.m. and noon, and one full-length evening performance at 7. The daytime performances are only 1 hour and 15 minutes long. Uptown Dance Academy, the Dance Theater of Harlem. Holiday Delight Sunday Matinee is this Sunday, December 7th. Two performances only, 2 p.m. and 5 p.m., featuring Dance Theater of Harlem School in excerpts from The Nutcracker, Apollo's Ellington at Christmas, A Kwanzaa Celebration, and special guest artists. The location is the Dance Theater of Harlem, Everett Center for the Performing Arts, 466 West 152nd Street, between Convent and Amsterdam. In Harlem, dancetheaterofharlem.org is their website, and their telephone number is 212-690-2800. My good friend Rome Neal is back in action. He sent me this, and I'm just going to read it the way he wrote it because he wrote it so well. Folks, here's the perfect date night, all at the New Eureka Poets Cafe, 236 East 3rd Street between Avenues B and C on Saturday, December 6th. Great theater and awesome jazz with complimentary banana pudding. See Helena D. Lewis's Adelco Award winner for Best Solo Performance in Call Me Crazy, 7 p.m., and jazz crooner Rome Neal and his amazing quartet singing Nothing But Love songs at 9:30 p.m. Go to newyorican.org for more information and to get your ticket. NUYORICAN.org. And for those of you that have heard, Ain't Misbehavin' is a hit in Harlem, and it has been extended to December 21st. It was supposed to close on November 23rd. It's doing such good business. People love it so much that they have extended it until December 21st at the Faison Firehouse Theater in the heart of Harlem at 124th Street and St. Nicholas Avenue. It's on 124th between St. Nicholas, 8th Avenue and Morningside, right where they all come together. The Apollo Theater presents Ellington at Christmas, the Nutcracker Suite featuring TV and Broadway star Norm Lewis on Broadway doing Phantom of the Opera, and the jazz vocalist Liz Wright with performances by the David Berger Jazz Orchestra, Priscilla Baskerville, Jason Samuel Smith, students from the Dance Theater of Harlem, and Arts High School Advanced Choir of Newark, New Jersey, under the musical direction of David Berger, Saturday, December 13th, 3 and 8, Sunday, December 14th, 3 o'clock, at the Apollo Main Stage. The Apollo Theater is at 253 West 125th Street. Go to the box office or call Ticketmaster. Soul Nativity 2014 at the Harlem School of the Arts is presented by the Theater Department December 12 through 14 and December 19 through 21. The Harlem School of the Arts Theater is at 645 St. Nicholas Avenue. This piece tells the story of the Nativity in an innovative and musically charged way, employing a score heavily influenced by classic R&B and soul acts. As part of HSA's season dedicated to Harlem, all of the musical arrangements are inspired by famous acts that have played the Apollo. Guest appearances from the Daughters of Flame of the Abyssinian Baptist Church, the incredible music of Thomas Donker and Global Soul, the Harlem Japanese Gospel Choir, and music direction by Jeffrey Bolding. Miss Mimi... Oh, yes, Miss Mimi Jones is appearing with her group Fridays, 8:30 until 11:30 at the Bar Thalia on Broadway and 95th Street. No cover charge. There's a small suggested donation, and the donation may be used toward food and beverage. This week with Rodney Green on drums, Luis Perdomo on piano, Mark Shim on sax, and Mimi Jones on bass. Schaumburg, last thing I want to tell you about this week, and then I'll be back next week. First Fridays at the Schaumburg is tomorrow at 6 o'clock. Their very popular monthly social gathering has live music, signature drinks, and extended viewing hours in the gallery. Here's the thing. They're going to be screening Best Man Holiday at 7 o'clock downstairs in the American Negro Theater. Upstairs in the lobby, dance, network, and mingle to the mixes of DJ Missy B and DJ Craig Nice for free. Okay? That's all I need to say about that. Coming up next week, Community Works New Heritage Theater Group is presenting a conversation with Whcr Rivers and Woody King Jr. on A Life in the Theater. Phyllis Yvonne Stickney is home for the holidays and bringing back the funny at Mist Harlem December 19th. And on Tuesday, I'm going to the opening of Madiba Restaurant at Mist Harlem. And I'll tell you all about that when I get back next week. So that's a few things that are going on that ought to keep you busy till I come back next week. You think? Maybe. I think so. I want to end tonight's show with some music, some seasonal music. I want to play Yolanda Adams. It Came Upon a Midnight Clear, which she sings magnificently. And then I want to end with the Wyans, B.B. Wyans, from the play Nativity, Mary's Story. Mary, did you know? So, oh, actually, you know what? I'm not going to end with that. How much time? I got 7 minutes and I got four. Yeah, I might have to end with that. I was going to play Ordinary People. I'm not going to be able to play Ordinary People because I don't have enough time, and it's a 6-minute track with Stephanie Mills and Ebony Joanne, so I may have to start next week's show with that. The point of it is that in these troubling and trying times that we are in, God uses ordinary people to bring about miraculous change. So don't be discouraged. Hold your head up. We are powerful, powerful people, and we'll get through this. All right? You're listening to Black Beat New York, the Flo Wiley Show. By the grace of God, I'll be right back next week. I hope that you will, too.
It came upon a midnight clear, that glorious song of old, from angels bending near the earth to touch their harps of gold. Peace on earth, goodwill to men, gracious King, thy world in solemn stillness lay to hear the angels sing. Can they sing a midnight glory? With peaceful wings unfurled, and still the heavenly music flows over all the weary world. Above its sad and lowly plains, they bend on heavenly wings. Oh, midnight clear, on a midnight, and every
would one day walk on water. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would heal our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make us new? And the child that you will deliver will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to the blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm the storm with his hands? And did you know that your baby boy would walk where angels try? And when you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Mary, did you know?
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Children of abuse, fight to stay alive. Shattered relationships, no one tries to say. Misunderstandings taken to the grave.
People locked deep down inside, trying not to show. Because of foolish pride, but pain is a sickness that is hard to cover, and it's the reason we mistreat each other.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen of the listening audience. I'm Maurice Selby.
And this is Sean Shivers.
And you're listening to Health in Harlem on WHCR 90.3 FM New York, the voice of Harlem.
The voice of Harlem.
And tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we have a full house.
Full house.
Full house. We have Ms. Dr. Lisa Gay Robinson, MD, MPH. We have Julia Floyd. She's a health educator at Harlem Hospital. And we have Dr. Pamela Guthrie.